Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to part 2, where we are descending down to Munich. And it is currently close to nighttime, as you guys can see. We're sending now passing flight level 150 down, and we're cleared down to 5,000. No ATCs, so we cleared ourselves down to 5,000, which is our final approach fixed altitude. Our rate will be medium, and we're using flaps 3. Decision height will be 104. Radial. We're using ILS category 3. We're expected to have clouds. In fact, there should be clouds here right now, but active sky hasn't updated quite yet. And look at that. DSF problems. Love it. Alright, anyways. So you can see here, flaps 3 config is enabled, so GPS flaps 3. And yeah. So this is the setting. See, actually, the beacon light here. That's kind of cool. Unfortunately, reflections only work very well at nighttime. Daytime, they're kind of negated. And it fixed a lot of it in a few last betas and updates where you can actually see reflections at daytime now, but it's not great. It's not as good as nighttime. Of course, I mean, everything's more reflective at nighttime. That's realistic and obvious. But a lot of still reflective at daytime too, so like if the sun directly casts on the aircraft, you'll see that there's no reflections directly on the aircraft. In the real world there would be, but not here. I don't explain at the moment. So we got some traffic. Minute, and then this guy should give us accurate wind. Well, not winds. We already got quite accurate winds, but accurate clouds again. Okay, 10,000 landing lights coming on. Constraint landing system constraint. NTIs would be needed at this time if there were clouds, but I don't know if there are clouds. Yes, right now at the moment there are none, but active sky still needs to update, and you'll probably see a lot of clouds appear. Clear down to 5,000, so we'll go and set our QNH, which is expected to be 1025. Yeah, 1025 once. 025 twice. And 1025 three times. Alright. The whole reason why I chose ILS is because we're expecting some clouds, I think, at 900 feet. Check our, nope, even 400 feet, broken at 400. Well, that's it, apparently. Overcast at 300, scattered at 500. So, yeah. We're expecting something. Just a 200. She also said it's 210. We'll set our speed to 23. Actually, 220. Activate approach phase. And with that, we'll also do our approach checklist. Approach briefing completed. ECOM status is checked. Decision height is 104. Suitable times are on. Auto break is medium. This should be few at 100 and broken at 200. But I don't see anything. Go and do flaps one. go. It looks like we captured. Not a very good capture, but it's fine. Anti-ice. Engine anti-ice coming on. Let's set speed 200, or actually 190. Flaps coming to, gear coming down, spoilers for arm, lights set for landing, so 160. Flaps 3 for landing. Landing checklist cam signal is not yet given. Alright, so we'll wait until this shows up. What's our status? Increased fuel consumption.
2,000.
Okay, cam signal is given. TGST. Alright, auto throttle is speed. And gear down through green, eco memo is landing no blue. Okay, and checklist is completed and we're clear to land. On the throttle.
About 200. Minimum.
Continue.
100. 50. 40. 30.
Retard. Retard.
10.
5.
Knots, manual braking, reverse stowed. Actually, that stays off. Standby off. After landing checklist. What's up with this? Anyways. Flaps are retracted, landing lights are off, spoilers are disarmed, radar is off. So you guys is standby and APU is on. Not sure why this is showing up. That's cool. Unfortunately, the crawling ants ruined the experience. The sand plugin, and it's really cool. It's like the first time I've ever tried it. It was so cool to use. Slides are disarmed, that's good. Alright, so parking checklist. Parking brake and chocks are on and in, engines are off, beacon is off, seatbelt signs are off, emergency exit lights off, yellow electric pump off, fuel pumps are off. Our parking check is completed. With that, I conclude this flight. Nice, left door is open. Thank you guys for watching, I hope you guys enjoyed these videos, and I will see you in another videos, hopefully before I move. So thanks again, and till next time, see you guys.